much longer. And they're usually here by now. If they're going to keep on taking and bringing your telly back, then you want to get a firm that's more punctual.
They're not so bad averaged out over the year. Once when I had a bad run with the GGs, they kept it in for 4 weeks. They used to let me go round and watch it on Saturday afternoons in the workshop.
And how he's got the blasted cheek.
Practice.
Oh, they said they were glad too. They said it was cheaper than running it back and forth.
Have you ever thought of simply keeping up the payments?
We all have these rash moments when we've had a few, don't we? But the next morning, it's back to reality.
I don't know why they bother with him. They must need a customer like him. Either need watercress and a jockstrap.
I understand that his influence dates from the time when he caught the manager adjusting a horizontal hold on her from the record counter.
Ah, in broad daylight, during the dinner hour, on the chess bench. I did not get a touch of the static. And I'd only nipped in for him to solder this earring. Ah, there we are.
Yes, they bloody have.
Eric's a qualified engineer.
Well done, Eric.
They did it all in that.
Very commendable.
Yeah, it was him what soldered all the earrings for me, Eric.
Not everybody would.
We won't do it again, though.
Why not?
Well, they didn't let him keep it deep.
Well, I got to kill you then. One player, three spectators.
You know, we'd like to help the Eric, but it's a question of the insurance. You're the only one who could drop me a big coin. Of course, since he's been qualified, he'd know much like the Olympic clubs.
I'm not so keen on them either.
Right, but he wasn't qualified.
Where's that bloke, Captain Eric? He's been bringing it lately.
Fell off the stupid roof, didn't he? But we fixed the area, we said. So now he's got a putt on. He's been grounded.
Batty, my true love, my own little me tumble. It gets dafter. She spoke to me. You heard her, she spoke to me. All right, take it downstairs, Eric. You know what it goes. Oh, my little Nora, Dora, don't you come near me.
For one thing or another, he leads a fairly full and active life.
No.
He's about as much use to the community as who's been gone.
Nora,
why does he keep chasing that woman?
Because it's more fun than actually catching.
I shall fetch me up. Oh, Nora, come out of that woolly jumper and them baggy drawers. The real thing.
The way he embarrasses people.
And it's entirely self-taught. He's never had a lesson in his life.
There he is. He's been on about me drawers again. Tell him. Well, say something to him.
Hey, would you come for?
Don't chat to him! Terrify him! You're out here to frighten him!
Was he didn't want your television back?
But they were late, though. Satanic, he's a bit mulchy.
Hey, I heard that.
Oh, that Eric!
Are you going to let him do what he likes with me?
What's to like about it?
Ask him if he's aware that he's lewd and obscene.
Of course he's aware. Everybody knows he's lewd and obscene, don't they?
Aye, it's common knowledge. How's it been?
Not so clever this season.
Don't you care? Don't you care?
Of course I care, woman. I don't spend all that bloody money on corn for him to come rolling home after everybody else's.
He is to have a woman to care for him and carry him about like that.
I think he's in love again, Cyril. You can almost tell when his teeth go that funny colour, white.
You don't think he's cleaning them again, do you? My God, here we go.
It's blowing in the wind, Jones.
It sounds like music, Miss Plum.
It is music. The sound of liberation. This is the age of liberation, Jones. What is it?
The age of liberation
Miss Probert?
A few years ago, you'd been the slave of some male.
Do you really think so, Miss Probert?
Definitely. You'd have been nothing more than a sexual object.
How fortunate to have escaped such a humiliation.
You'd have been the plaything of some masculine oaf.
Instead of which, I'm free.
Lonely. The librarian.
You are not lonely, Jones. You are liberated. You've got the fellowship of the movement. The comradeship of every emancipated brother female.
Oh, goody.
You like men.
I can't help it.
Well, of course you can help it, Jones. Our chairwoman did. She went through the minefield of divorce for the love of a lady traffic warden. That simple response to the call of duty which distinguishes our movement, Jones.
I was very fond of Mr. Protheroe. I even felt a sort of gentle affection for his strangely non-symmetrical legs.
Commit yourself to us, Jones, and I promise you this. You'll find many amongst us with non-symmetrical legs. Some cheeky hound's got a wireless on in here.
I thought I could hear music, Miss Probert.
You have dropped it, the clangor I've been waiting for. I've had my eye on you, you're out.
These gentlemen were back for me, I was just sitting there.
Out!
Perusing through some of your educational literature.
This minute,
when
now!
Suddenly this complete stranger come up and put this tranny in my hand.
Unsolicited music on library premises. That's typical masculine arrogance. Out!
Go on, lads, I'm appealing to you.
I don't find it very appealing, do you?
Who is he? Oh, come on, don't walk about.
Out!
Don't ask me, I've never seen him before.
His head's a funny shape.
Will you get out, or do I have to use my power under the bylaws?
I mean, what do we know about him except that he likes trickly music?
He reminded me of somebody.
Ah, that's exactly the epitaph that I'd like on my gravestone.
He knows how to wear clothes.
Out. Hello, hello, hello. He's given himself up for fingerprinting.
Perhaps it's his initials. You must be joking. Don't you like a challenge?
No.
Yeah, they can put them down. Them's private and personal. I took them with our Barry's instant thingy. I had to. Well, I asked her for a photo, but she wouldn't give me one.
Well, only because she doesn't like you. It wasn't anything personal.
Not like him, she can't stand him. I had a list of untouchables. He comes somewhere between cobwebs in corners and defective drains.
I'm going to wear her down with the power of my passion.
He must be crackers. She's a bigger knack than my missus.
I can't help it if I hear music whenever she goes by.
Music? Her? Must be mood music, all that.
He's up to something. All impetuous in Wellington boots.
If we were dead nosy, you see, we probably would have followed him.
Wally, put your arm in.
Yeah, get my Wally.
Yes, I thought he might be with you.
No, I haven't seen him.
Nearly a week now.
Yes, much better, of course, without him.
Oh, yes, lots of fun. Anyway, it saves on fags.
I must say, without him, the standard of debate is immeasurably higher.
By God, it is, yes.
I mean, look what he discussed yesterday. In depth, for 3 hours. The implications of a reduction in the bandwidth.
Is that what it was, 3 hours?
Yes, the time just goes, you see.
Whizzes by, doesn't it? Like a snail up a drainpipe. 3 hours, I thought it was a week.
Well, it wouldn't drag if we had the right topic. It's all we want is the right topic.
Fancy Wally Batty leaving home.
And I don't mean gossip. We don't need gossip, people of our intelligence.
We need livening up. I see that young lady has got a touch of the spring again.
I should think so, like a holiday for her. No Compo Simonites scattering fag ends and crumbs round her reference section.
Is that all it takes? I wonder if he realizes how much happiness he spreads just by keeping out of the road.
Phantom employment avoided of the Social Security.
Seeking here, they're seeking there. Me and Nora have got to stick together. We're the only two left on this road. Which reminds me, I have an appointment in a minute. I'm expected for morning cocoa.
Very space age.
Yeah, well, Wally, she gave it to him for his birthday. She said I might as well wear it.
Getting you broken into a schedule, is she?
Don't you worry about me.
Something very sinister about all this. Him becoming hygienic overnight.
Yeah, well, I'm sorry, lad. You've called at a very awkward time. I've got to go. And she's very particular about time. Is Nora. So I'm Enchanted evening. You'll meet the Lone Ranger.
Wearing a collar and tie.
Get away.
Aye. Not the one he usually wears to keep up the tops of his trousers.
How's he keeping them up?
Well, he's wearing Wally's suits.
I'm a cheeky monkey. I'm only stepping into another bloke's shoes, but...
And he's wearing them and all.
Oh, stone me if I enter Liberty.
Well, Liberty's about the last thing it is. She's nearly got him on a lead already. I can't understand him. He's going to be indistinguishable from any other trained domestic performer.
Hey, do you mind? We've still got our pride, you know. It's only the nerve that's gone.
Sorry.
I know I've not always been complimentary to him, especially when downwind of his feet. But I have no wish to see him going to a fate worse than death with a smile on his stupid face.
I wonder if he is in all that deep or whether he's up to something. I know he was untidy, but you've got to admit that with proper training, he could be a real devious little twat. There was something about that wink he gave us.
His eye were bloodshot.
No, it was something else. I think we ought to have a word with Wally Batty. Husband and escapee. He may have the key to this lot.
It might help if we knew why he left home.
Hey, you better go tell one look at Nora to know why he left home.
Oh, yes. Motionless again. What do you think you are, the spirit of passive resistance?
Oh, get back through. I'm coming.
Coming? You've been coming all day. If you stick there much longer, they'll be posting flaming bills on you.
Hey, watch this space.
How can I? It's always stuck to a flaming chair.
Hey, if you do see Wally Batty, ask him if he's got any tips on how he escaped.
Oh, you come at you and
I... They say I will throw on anything. He's never thrown on me.
He loves him, really, so he says.
Compo tell you?
No, you're going back.
Oh, aye. I
told him not to lift.
Some enchanted evening. Oh, but you may see a stranger.
Hey, up, don't go up there. Up, I'm expecting company.
He's expecting company, fancy.
Yes, come on, you'll have to clear up. It's private.
I bet it is. Saucy little devil.
Look, I've got a Chinese meal in that oven. It cost me half a quid.
Big spender, you've done it now. It's marriage she's after.
I told you, worry about me.
He thinks he's safe from matrimony because Wally is coming back.
He's got no scruples whatsoever. And he's also run out of luck because we have just left Wally Batty at the airport.
Divorce papers in the post.
Never coming back again.
Gone forever.
Decided to stay and enjoy his freedom.
He's only going to see his pigeons.
Via New Zealand.
Hasn't he got a funny colour?
He doesn't look well, does he?
Oh, Nora. Oh, bloody hell.
When did he go? Nora, they're going to have to get me out of it.
Tonight, that's at 9 here on UK TV Drama. You Rang My Lord is next.